them now. Revoke them now.
You're an embarrassment to us, the media and the government. Listen to all of you. Face heavy on.
You are the clever ones, so give yourselves a round of applause for being here today.
The protest outside Parliament might only have represented a minority of New Zealanders, but it exposed an ugly and even threatening opposition to Aotearoa's public health measures. Auckland Councillor Josephine Bartley didn't need any reminding. She has personally been the target of threats and intimidation while helping with the vaccination rollout. After an incident last week, she woke to discover a security guard positioned outside her home. Josephine Bartley is back on the front lines today, helping with a mass vaccination event at Mount Smart Stadium in Tāmaki Makaurau. Tēnā koe. Thanks so much for being with us, Josephine. How is that event going? I've got to be honest, it looks wet.
Kia ora, Jack. Talofa lava to everybody out there. Yeah, look, this is how community rolls. It's raining, it's cold, but already cars are lining up out there here at Mount Smart at our Megavax Pacific event. So that's just how we are as community. We all come together and we're vaccinating. Pacific Leadership Forum, South Seas Healthcare, Busfika Family Health Group, our church leaders, we've already finished our prayers. So many prayers today. But yeah.
It's really
good
to see.
We're just doing it.
Yeah.
No matter the weather.
It's really, really good to see, Josephine. Hey, so for people who perhaps aren't familiar with all of the work you've been doing and don't know about some of the things you've experienced over the last couple of weeks, could you tell us about some of the pressures and intimidation that you have experienced in assisting with this vaccination rollout?
Okay, thank you. Thank you for the question. I've been facing a bit of backlash regarding supporting the vaccination program. But however, it's not just me. There's so many others that are receiving the same kind of online threats and abuse. Our Pacific providers are getting threats and online, you know, hate really on their Facebook pages. Our young people, you know, from their own peers. So I give it over to our young people, our Pasifika young people. I'm hearing about bubblegum youth and, you know, their friends that are anti-vax, vaccine hesitant, and they're pushing through with supporting vaccination events in the community, all of our young people. So some real leaders are emerging through this pandemic. And it is people from our community. So I give it over to them. You know, what I go through, everybody says, you know, it's to be expected. You're a counsellor, that's what you get. But the stuff coming through from the kind of extreme anti-vax is scary, really scary stuff. So, you know, people should not be trying to stop other people taking care of themselves, their families and their communities by getting vaccinated. Just using their own words back on them, freedom of choice. Leave these people alone to use their own freedoms to get vaccinated.
For people who perhaps aren't quite familiar with just how extreme some of the sentiment has been, can you give us an example of what you personally have experienced? People saying threatening things to you in the street?
Yeah, sure. I don't want to talk like it's flippant, but, you know, things like calling me scum, that they'll just vandalise my car instead, that we're a disgrace to our race, that we're exploiting our own communities by putting on these vaccination events with incentives, injecting, I don't even want to talk about the negative stuff, but injecting, you know, the Antichrist in your arm, you know, things like that. That's what we're all facing by supporting the vaccination rollout, that we're going to burn in hell, you know, things like that. But yeah, that is not what we focus on. We focus on saving lives.
Yeah.
That this vaccination, these vaccines will save lives.
Yeah, that's a really important message. Maybe then tell us how you work through that. In the face of all of those threats and intimidation, how do you and the teams that you're working with try and put that to one side and continue with your mahi?
I think, you know, like everybody here, even though it's raining, I mean, we'd much rather probably be at home watching Netflix in our bubbles with our families. But everybody here is here out of love and out of service. Tautua, alofa, that's what motivates us. And that's why we come out here. We do these vaccination events in the community every week. And it's not just me. It's all of these people out here. These whaifea owls, these church leaders, Pacific Leadership Forum, you know, our providers. I think they're like machines. They can just keep going. So many vaccination events every week, every weekend, late night, you know, even the schools are getting involved. Everybody's just going hard to get that vaccination rate up not just because they want to get the numbers. It's not about the numbers, it's about saving people's lives. So, yeah.
Totally.
This is how we keep going, by being around each other
and
supporting each other.
Josephine, over the last couple of weeks, hundreds of people in your community have been isolating at home with COVID-19. What have those people been telling you about the experience?
Yeah, I think, you know, it just seems to me like people don't realise how widespread COVID is and how COVID is actually in our communities. I'm not sure why, but people seem to think that COVID is within a certain boundary, within a certain phone code in Auckland, but it is out there. I have people in my area that are self-isolating through COVID. How do I know this? I know this because I deliver food parcels to those households. So, you know, it's out there, and people are self-isolating at home as opposed to going into MIQ. They don't want to go to MIQ because of the negativity they've seen around the experience. So they don't want to put themselves and their families, their children, through that. So they choose to stay home and self-isolate, which again is a concern, because what is the support that is going around them while they're self-isolating with COVID in their households?
Yeah, I wanted to ask you about that. For the last 2 weeks on Q&A, we have identified some problems regarding people who are isolating at home, people who've been sent the wrong information by health authorities. And this week, Health Minister Andrew Little accepted that the system was not up to scratch when we began the home isolation system. What is your view on that?
Yeah, I'm glad the minister said that, because that's the truth. You know, what we learnt from this vaccination rollout is, if you really want to get to the hard to reach, to our diverse communities, then you give it over to the community to do. That's where we see the success of things like these vaccination events, was once the Pasifika providers got involved, our communities got involved, then you saw the numbers go up of the vaccination, because community knows how to reach community. I would say do the same with the families that are self-isolating. Get our community providers, our Pacific providers, Māori providers, health providers, get them in there to work with the families. That's how you're going to, you know,
Support
have a more
them
effective
more.
Response.
And so what would
Absolutely.
You do if community organisations have greater involvement? What sorts of things would they do to support people who are isolating at home with COVID-19?
I think it starts off even from the first approach. You know, like I'm hearing from families that what they got, what they received when they found out they had COVID was a welcome pack, you know, a pack about having COVID. You've got to do more than that. And ideally, you've got to, you know, it's how you approach the family, how you talk to them, who's doing that approach. Ideally, it's going to be, you know, if it's a Pasifika family, ideally Pasifika, because you're already scared because you've got COVID. A lot of people have COVID, they won't come forward with it because they're scared. Fear is a very dominating factor in this whole thing to do with COVID. Some people have it, they don't want to know they have it, they don't want to go to MIQ. It's just very scary, so the first approach is most important.
Yeah. Josephine, I can see that fear is not a factor for you. Thank you so much for your time and for the great work you and your community are doing there at Mount Smart Stadium. That's Josephine Bartley.